Walkabout Mini Golf. Now this is actually a pretty fun game, whether you're playing it by yourself or if you've got a group and you want to play in a multiplayer. So as you can see, we have a few balls sitting here for us and a few clubs. Now later on in the game, you can actually upgrade and get more balls and more clubs that are a little bit cooler. Now to get more balls, we have to go and find the lost balls. So that's the whole purpose of this video, is to help you find all those lost balls. So let's go ahead and get to it. Okay, so I'm going to use my teleport feature just to get over here, because I know that ball is right over there. So here's our first ball. As you can see, it's not even far from where you start. So, next we're going to head on over to hole number two. And sometimes what I do is, instead of just sitting here looking around, well, I'll do it for the next one, but the second ball is right here. The first course, balls are actually pretty easy to find. They're not that far from the hole. Okay, now this is the one that I'm going to go ahead and what I'm going to do is point my stick up, take my analog stick on my controller, and just push it up and hold it until it starts to fly. And what this does is it gives you a better view, so that way you can spot those lost balls, like this one here, hiding, not even on the course. That's why using the flying feature is pretty good, at least for lost balls, and then of course later on the harder level for the foxhunts. So now we're going to move on to number four, which is located right here. And again, I'm going to go ahead and just fly, because I think it makes it easier to find the lost balls. And right off the bat, there it is. I get that some people might not be able to use the flying feature because of motion sickness. What I usually do is I'll sit down, just get a nice sturdy chair, sit down, and it usually won't hit you as hard. But if it does, I mean, just do a little bit at a time and work up to it. So we're moving on to course number five, which is right here. And up I go. I turn over this way a little bit so that we can locate that next ball. And I'm pretty sure it is, if I remember correctly, should be right around there. It is. Go ahead and just fly on over here. It's pretty close, and I don't know if we got this one already or not. Yeah, actually, yeah, we did. We did. So what we're gonna do is head on in here. As you come in, you can already see where that lost ball is. Same thing over here, just gonna fly. And now you can use your controller, that same analog stick, to turn yourself. Or, but if you've got enough space, you can actually, your pole will actually, or your club will actually guide you around. And there is our next ball. Depending on how much space you have in your play area, you can either, that's your, there's another one, you can guide yourself with your club. But if you don't have a lot of space, and I can already see that next one right there, if you don't have a lot of space, you can just go ahead and use the analog like that to turn yourself. But let's go ahead and grab that ball right there. And we're gonna do that. The easy way to see. Oh, we missed six. Let's go back to six. Tricky. Where did I miss it? There it is. I thought I got it. Okay, so we went back and got six. You can see where it's located. Little table, the awning, right there. Okay, so let's go ahead and skip. I can't believe we missed that one and went that far. Okay, we'll go ahead and move on to location 11, which is located right over here. There's a cool ship over there. Actually, okay, no, that's the same ship. Broken in half. Beautiful waterfall. Nice little track over here, but I'm gonna go ahead and load up so that I can look and see where this next one's. But sometimes they're actually on the side, like they go with that one in the bushes, but I think this one is actually no, I'm wrong. There it is. There it is. See, and I play through this. And even I get a little lost finding these lost balls. Now, I'm not working in a very big play area, so I'm going to actually use the analog stick more, but there's our next one. And you can keep going back to your menu, and you just hit the A button to get back up to this menu here. So that way you can see along the way which ones you've collected and which ones you still need to go. So we're moving on to 13, which is right over here, right next to that little house or shack, whatever it is. Okay, so once again, I am going to fly because that's just my preferred way. That makes it quicker and easier for me to get over here to our next ball. Oh, stolen crossbows. Or stolen swords. Sorry. Okay, so moving on to location 14. It's over here by the ship. Okay, so normally, and I've already played through the course, the balls aren't here, but normally you would tee off right here. But we're just going to go ahead and fly on down and collect this ball that's inside this half of the ship. Sometimes I stand while I'm flying, but I get a little wobbly sometimes when I do that. I'd like to think that I caught my VR legs already, but every once in a while I'll play something and it will show me otherwise. So, our next ball is right over here. Okay. So now we're going to move on to hole number 16. And it's right in front of my face. Standing right on top of it. And I'm going to go ahead and fly up. And around this location. As you see, it's not really that big. Well, yeah, it is. That's just the first part. But still, before we even get up to the hole, there's our next lost ball. I'll go ahead and just fly this time. sometimes you'll see little bits of wood that are peeking out, and it kind of tricks you into thinking that there's something there. A lot of times you'll find them in many places, like around the barrels. Let's see if I can remember where this one is at. Not over here. See, this one is so long. I mean, look at it, all these little pieces. And this is just one hole. It's got layers. And then you get it down here and you've got to shoot it down again. So we're just going to go ahead and, oh, there it is. Before we even made it down, it's not hard to miss that, or not hard. We'll just skip over that one. Reverse that. Let's see where we are. Oh, we missed number 17. Okay, and we have collected all 18 balls. Some of them are a little trickier than others, which is why it's a good thing to pull up this little menu here, because then if you accidentally skip one, you can go back to it and try to find it. Okay, so I'm going to go back to the main menu, and you're going to see what happens to your little table full of golf balls once we get back with all these new lost golf balls. And here they come. Next time you can go through. I actually like this one here. See, that's the one that I was using, and this is a funny little thing. It's like, okay, this one's selected, but if I decide that maybe I'd rather go for this one. I just think it's funny. I like how it just kind of like kicks that ball out when you select a new one. And then over here, you just choose which club you want. I'm going to go ahead and stick with the black one. But that's all for today. So the next video, I'll go ahead and we'll move on to Cherry Blossom, and we'll locate the lost balls in that area. And then later on, we'll come back and do the fox hunt. Because once you collect all the balls, you open up the fox hunt. So thank you so much for playing mini golf and finding, well, not really playing mini golf, but locating lost golf balls with me, and I'll see you soon. Make sure that you like and subscribe to my channel for more videos.